Welcome to DOS Storm. Today I'll be showing you the easiest way to run old 16-bit Windows applications on modern 64-bit Windows. Obviously, it's more fun in my opinion to play on OG hardware, but not everyone wants to lug around an old CRT or try and find an old computer with eBay scalper pricing these days. So here's an easy alternative for modern systems. First thing you will need is a program called WINEVDM, which I'll link below, but you can easily bring it up with a quick search. Basically, this program is much like Wine on Linux, but in this case, we're just using it to run 16-bit programs. You're going to want to download the latest version of the OTVDM zip file and extract it to the folder location of your choice. As an example, I'll be installing the classic game Exile, Escape from the Pit. As you can see, the program refuses to run when I click the installer. So go back to the folder you dumped your WineDVM install and run the OTDVMWEXE file. You can then browse to the 16-bit program of your choosing and it should run. In the case of Exile, it launches a setup program to install the game. You can install it like normal. Now again, the game itself will not run much like the installer did. So you can either load the OTVDMWEXE file every time and browse to the application to play the game, or you can set up a quick shortcut. Here's an easy way to create a shortcut. Right click on the OTVDMWEXE and click Send to Desktop. Once you create the shortcut, right click on it and enter Properties. In the target, make a space after the OTVDMWEXE and type or paste the location of the 16-bit program you want to run. Now under Start In, type or paste the folder of where the 16-bit program is running from. In this case, it's C Exile. Now if you want to get really fancy, you can add the original icon from the program if you wish to. If you click Apply, you should be able to launch the program easily from this simple shortcut. There you go. Now you can play all your favorite Windows 3.1 games on modern Windows. It is also worth mentioning that there is a Winhelp file exe in the OTDVM folder that allows you to open old help files. Like anything, this isn't a perfect solution, and you may not be able to run every program using it. In my experience though, most simple programs from this time period run flawlessly. Rodent's Revenge, Castle of the Winds, and oh yeah, Ski Free. They all seem to work pretty well. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Many more videos will be coming like this every week with a focus on vintage games and hardware. So give me a like and a sub if that sounds good to you. See you in the next one.